Hey, hi, is anybody home today? I forgot to get the thing to. I knew this was going to be a problem. Hey, is anybody home today? What are you doing? I said I was coming on. Where are you? So I want to show you this quick dip that I was going to have for dinner, but now I clearly have a date. This is my new shabby chic dress. Friends, if you all live in Spartanburg, South Carolina, or you have a Dillard's, friends, this had been $89. I don't know who would pay that, but it has a slip underneath. It's very like high quality. It has a zipper down the side, huh? Has a little stretchy back and like a scoop back. You don't need to see all that, okay? It's a date night. But it had been $89, and it was on sale for $31.15. And then it was half off that. I got this dress for $16. It is the cutie. Do you all want to see? Hi, it's date night. It is the cutie. And then I have on the faux boots. Huh? What do you think? It's hippie shabby chic with the Mountain Mommy Only For Me edition. And then this, which, hello. Hey, what are you doing? So we have a date. But what I was going to tell you, this is a great thing though, because this dip, all I have to do is put it in my Debbie Meyer, which is a brand, green box, and it will last till tomorrow. But I want to show you what's in this. This is a great stretch the fat recipe. Now, I'll get to that in a minute. But anyway, this will be great in the middle of sweet pepper scoopers, which I was just in the midst of doing. You would want to remove the rest of that green. Unless you're me, and I would just eat it. Do you all remember years ago when I would make recipes with you, which I'm getting back into, and if you want to see how this recipe is made, I have the whole clip. It's up in the Insta stories on my Tannyraw Instagram. Join me in the community of love and light, where it's all support, all love, everything you need, and nothing you don't, okay? So anyway, all the recipes, I have got, I don't know, 8,020 posts over there, and most of them have the recipes, but up in the Insta stories, you go up to the top, you click on my circle, it's the eyeball, and then you can see live where I'm usually chitter-chattering, and you can see what's going on in the day. Maybe there's some just giving you some encouragement to, I don't know, freshen up your makeup, fluff your hair, like feel good about yourself. Maybe if you're a dude, like you're gonna do a little weights in the afternoon. Maybe if you're a girl, I don't know, whatever it is to refresh yourself, like you're not just put on this earth to work your job that you don't even like, and that's all. Like, so anyway, over on Instagram, Tannyraw, join me there. I would love to have you. It's my favorite place to be. But this would be great in these pepper scoopers. Anyway, if you've watched me for a long time on YouTube, do you all remember I made a carrot soup one time, and the red pepper, it had a sticker on the side. And people are like, Tanny, you ate that! Listen, this is the real life broadcast. You know what I'm saying? So you could use these. You could also use any kind of peppers. You could use celery stalks. You could put this inside of romaine boats. You could put it in collard green wraps. You could put it, I don't know, I told you celery, anything. You could also have it as like a mock meat type situation in a taco salad if you add a little taco seasoning in there. But right now I want to show you how dense this is, okay? So here we have it, and you're wondering what the heck is that, aren't you? This is, do you all understand the size? Hello, do you understand the size? It smells good too. I'm trying not to eat because Greggy's taking me out, and I was frankly quite whiny yesterday. I was like, listen, when is it Tanny's time? He's a very busy man, and I am not used to having to fight for a man's attention, especially the man I love. And so, he's coming down. He has three kids, and I have to share him. And anyway, so I want to tell you what's in this, but I want you to look at how large this is. And if you made this ahead of time, you could also triple the recipe. You could put some for tonight, okay? That will be serving one. Serving two, you could put in a Debbie Meyer green box and slide it in the fridgey. And serving three, you could freeze in a Ziploc freezer bag because those are BPA free. What you would want to do is you want to put it in there and kind of smush it out as flat as you can, zipper it all the way to the edge, and then suck out the air, which I won't do that for you, like mimic that, because it looks like I'm smoking drugs. Like, I don't know how many times I've done that. Stop laughing. So then you're going to flatten it out. You're going to put it in there, because then when you get it out and it's flat, Then, number one, you've gotten the air out, so there's no freezer burn. And number two, it will defrost quicker because it's not one big clump. Now, what is in this? And I want to just show you, just look at the density. Could you all get on board with that? Look. Oh, the raw food, it's not satisfying. That's because you're trying to eat oranges and leaves for dinner. I mean, that's a snack, you know? So I want to tell you what's in this, and I jotted it down for you. So we started out, I had gotten these organic baby bell mushrooms, which you can eat raw if you're wondering. There are some types of mushrooms that aren't good to eat raw, and you can look that up on the internet. Your phone knows that stuff. So anyway, two packages, which were about 12 ounces each, so 24 ounces of baby bell mushrooms. They were already washed and diced, which was convenient, and they were on sale. So I got that. Then we had, up in the Insta stories, I showed you taking about 1 cup of carrots, and I did a Vitamix wet chop. I have a video called Vitamix wet chop and wet chop baby. If you want to be entertained, check it out, because you'll be like, I can't believe that girlfriend did that. That was before I knew people were actually watching this broadcast. Is my only excuse. I don't know. You're like, I got to see that. Anyway, so what you do is you put the carrots in there, in this case, and then you're going to fill it up, plenty of water. Like, let's say you have 1 cup of carrots, you're going to have like 3 or 4 cups of water. You're going to turn it on full blast, and you're going to do a pulse. You're going to do a rant, let it drop, rant, let it drop, drain it out. And then you have these tiny little bitty pieces of carrots, which are little sweet slivers in here, and they add bulk and they add sweetness. Okay, so we have 1 cup of that. If you don't want to do that, you could chop them, but it's a good idea. Okay, then we have a handful of cilantro, depending on how you like that, how much you like of that. Now, if you don't like cilantro, use something else, right? No doubt. You could use parsley, flat leaf parsley. You could use dill, use some type of herb, you know? Okay, then we had about a tablespoon of Italian seasoning, which I put on after I got all this done. Then we had a little bit of cayenne pepper. Use your discretion on that. And it will depend on what type of cayenne you have too, because you might have a spicier one. And I like my food to kind of make me sweat. It's like I have the food and I have one of these and I take a bite and then I politely just blot, you know, because there'll be sweat beadlets. Okay, so anyway, then what else do we have? Oh, yes. Then I had about 4 to 6 ounces of alfalfa sprouts. Get the sprouts. You want to add in more living food in this year. You want to be more satiated, more energetic, more balanced, have more thought-provoking thoughts. You want to be on your game. Living food, live food for a live body. You know, eat to thrive. So we have 4 to 6 ounces of living food, which in this case was alfalfa sprouts. Then we had a little sprinkle of kelp sprinkle, kelp flakes, which is going to give you a little bit of salty component and some iodine in there, which is great for your body. Then, okay, I had all that in the bowl. I'm smashing it up together. Kind of, you're like, why didn't you do this? Because I was on Instagram and like I needed to try on my new dress and I thought that you could just follow along and you could come over there and I thought you might join me, huh? You want to see it, don't you? And so anyway, then we had a little bit of, that's all I had in there. I was going to put a little bit of diced dark raisins, but I didn't need it. The carrot gave it that sweet component. Okay, and then I had a half of what is called a slimcado. That's a type of avocado that almost the skin on the outside can resemble a papaya. Now, what the deal is with these is that they're a lot larger than, say, your standard Haas avocados, but they are less calorie dense and less fat in there. So basically, you can still have a half. It's much larger volume. Of course, it's going to depend on avocado to avocado, but you see what I'm saying? Less fat, more volume. And in a recipe like this, it's really good because you are really stretching that fat around. And you all might be saying, well, Tanny, they say good fat's good for me. Eat all the fat. Eat all, even if I'm doing intermittent fasting, I can eat all the calories and they don't matter. Friends and family, yes, they do. We love to hear good things about our bad habits. Now, if you want to go the all-fat route, I hope you're having no very, very little veggies. I hope you're having nothing else. Nothing. And then that might work for a very short stint of time. carbohydrates hydrate the body. And when you eliminate carbohydrates, you eliminate the hydration in your body. You deplete the glycogen in your muscle reserves, and you can actually drop a little bit of quick weight, which most of it is, in fact, water weight. Now, over time, could you continue to lose weight on that? Yes, you could, but you're going to have to actually create a calorie deficit. Now, in some people's case, a keto or that type of diet seems easier to them. Why is that? Because they've gotten over that little span of time where they are constantly being driven back in by these cravings and toxic addictions to sugar, salt, processed fat, all these things. Processed food and sugar are detrimental to your health, whether it is in vegan food or non-vegan food. But so in a way, they've gotten over those cravings a little bit. But here's the thing to me, why not do that in a way of eating all the whole plants? Fresh, whole, ripe, raw fruits and vegetables with an emphasis on low, though adequate amount of properly balanced plant fat, right? Emphasis on greens, living foods, sprouts, microgreens, water, hydration, you know, hot teas to get you through the cold evenings, you know? Anyway, it's a plan for longevity, okay? And there may be other routes, but you're here to talk about this, and I'm here to talk about it. And I hope you're picking up what I'm laying down, because I've been doing this. You know, it's 13 and a half years that I have been low-fat, raw vegan. And 5 years before that, that I was whole food, high, raw plants, okay, vegan. It has worked for me a long time. I have a video over on my tannyraw.com that tells you all of the diseases that I overcame with my lifestyle. And it's specific to me and a lot of people that I've helped over the years that even have come to terms with the fact that they could not stay on raw. Why was that? Well, to me, I'm looking at the diet and I can see why, because it's not having sympathy for somebody, it's having empathy because you've been there. You know what I mean? So anyway, let's have a little taste of this, and I don't want to drip on my new hippie chic here, but could somebody have a taste test? Can I get a volunteer? Should we have a song while I wait on a volunteer? Hey Mary, how are you? Mary is live and in the house. Can everybody say hey to Mary? But I have like two bundles of collard wraps. How many can you really have? Well, that depends on how good your dang digestive tract is, you know. For years and years, I used to think, I really believe in raw, but I couldn't eat it. I couldn't digest it until I could. Until I worked on building up the good bacteria in my guts and getting my gut tract out of dysbiosis, which is when the bad bacteria is outweighing the good bacteria. And what that bacteria wants is the same processed food that you raised it and grew it on, you know? I come from a background of a long history of gut disorders, and now I don't have that. So, you know, one leaf at a time, right? What do you think? Let's have a little song, and I'll take a question or two if y'all have something, and then I'm going to hop off here. It'll be time for Greggy very soon. Yes, it will. Can you name that song? Can anybody name it and claim it? Huh? I just talked to Paige earlier, Maritza. And I was thinking the other day, I was almost in Charlotte, North Carolina, which is very close to Paige. Yes. Nobody can name it? Name it and claim it. And I will call your name loud and proud. Yes, I will. Pretty Young Thing. Who is that? Showtime, Showtime in the house. Woo-hoo! That was good, because if that was in like Name That Tune, it was like three beats. You want to see the whole dress? You can. I should learn how to use this computer. I really should.
Thank you.
Has a little slip underneath. Slightly low for date night, you know? I want to love you. Pretty young thing. So, back to the chat. Now, let's have a taste test. Woo! Spicy. That is... I forgot to tell you an ingredient. If you wanted to hear the ingredients that were at the beginning of this chat, there was about... Why didn't I write that down? Three or maybe four. It's about 3 tablespoons of fresh squeezed lemon juice. And the lemon juice and cilantro, cayenne, and the avo. Very tasty. You know, when you get past cravings of crap, CSC, the cravings of crap, cock, that was bad. This is a live broadcast. Welcome to Granny's Office of Love and Light, where you just never know. Anyway, the CSC, you don't want it anymore. Okay, let's just see how this would look, would taste on. Can you? Come on! You can eat all this and still fit in all your pants. What do you think? Are you living in deprivation? Huh? Don't laugh. That was a dirty joke and I didn't even mean it. I mean, I did, but... Oh my, baby, let me love you down. You stop eating, Tanny. It's not time. My man has a lot going on, and I was very fussy yesterday, and I do not like to share him. I'm sorry. I'm not always easy to get along with. I know you're shocked. So if you're still being driven around by the COC, what are you doing? Huh? I love you. I hope you make this. And understand that if you have this prepped ahead, you can be successful. Well, I haven't been successful. I've been trying to do this 10 or 15 years. That's your own fault. You didn't know what to do, but now you do. And say, oh, well, that was my fault. I didn't know what to do. That was my fault. I wasn't prepping ahead. That was my fault. I wasn't trying to get in all the nutrients. That was my fault. I was trying to live on banana and date or aid. That was my fault. Because when you realize it's your fault and you take personal responsibility, you can take your health back. And health is your birthright. Did you know? What do you think? I have a live chat. I think I did yesterday on here. I felt like it was motivational for somebody. I don't know. If you want to hear some raw vegan preaching, please join me there. There's an altar call for the best version of yourself. Do you understand? Because I'm tired of you waiting. I am tired of you all watching this broadcast and not getting on with it. I am tired of you watching from the bleachers and saying, well, it's kind of a good game. You don't know how it feels to play. I'm tired of you coming with your snorkel and your earplugs and your swimmies, okay? And your water pamper. And you're just standing on the step. You don't know how it feels to dive into the deep end. What about now? I mean, after all, it's 2020. I don't know what else to say. If now's not the time, then when? Huh? It's the only game to play. Yes, it is. Let's just do it, shall we? Huh? Let's do it. up on my Instagram, I think it's still up there, I showed, somebody made a comment on a video that I did. It was about 5 or 6 years ago. And I took a screenshot of that and a screenshot of my hair now. Now, okay, if you're having vegan deterioration, I don't know what you're living on. If you're having raw vegan degeneration, what are you living on? Because I'm having regeneration, restoration. More of a year. So I know it's possible because I'm living it. Health is your birthright, but you have to name it and claim it, right? Like I said yesterday in that video, are people going to understand this dish? No, and I hope they don't, because if they understood, they might want me to share. And since they don't, it's all for me, right? I go to a festival, a Christmas party, or whatever. I bring my own food. And if they don't eat it, I bring it home. And I'm glad, you know? Regeneration. What do you think? You can feel good about yourself again. Or for the first time ever. You can feel like you're enough. And if you don't feel like that, and that's why you're not starting, I would suggest you regroup and understand that your life's slipping away, and now's the time. Now's the time. Right? For you to look in the mirror and say, I can't save the world, but I can save yours. And then I would begin to dance, you know? What do you think? The live chats in the reset, somebody's asking me. I have a program called the Raw Reset. It's a 30-day immersion program. Join me. Change your life. So the live chats are typically at 7 o'clock in the morning and 8 o'clock on Saturday. But the Saturdays are Q&As, and you must submit your questions pertaining to that week's topics ahead of time. And I'll tell you all about that coming Sunday and Monday. Okay, I'll tell you Sunday. There'll be a video in the group for you. And then Monday, I'll be alive and alive. But if you can't be there live, that doesn't matter, because then it's the pinned post for the whole day. And you just go and say, okay, I'm ready to watch. And you click on. And then it's up there for 24 hours until I do another one. Then that's the pinned post. After it's no longer the pinned post, it goes to the video section. And you can watch it all month. I give at least 30, 60, 90, more than 100 recipes for you there. It's everything you need and helping you eliminate everything you don't. I've never believed in anything more than that, because I've seen people change their lives in there. So if you're in my Raw Reset, I'll be seeing you Sunday and all month, and we'll become besties, and I'll say, hey, my new best friend, right? That'll be you. I love you. I hope you have a great day. Put on some lashes, some lip gloss, fluff your hair, and just dance in your kitchen. What do you think? My new thing for this winter, since I'm super pale, is a little blushy on the cheeks. I want to love you. Bye. Later, alligator.